tomorrow I'm going on a motorcycle trip for 5 days. Then this happened. So this tire's a little thin anyway. I'm close to the wear bar, but it probably would have made it, but I picked up a nail. We know how thin it gets up here, so I went and bought new tires. Today, we're changing the tires, BMW K1300S. Same process for 1200S, 1200R, whatever. Also, the TPMS batteries are dead. It's a 2011, so the batteries lasted about 9 years. They went out COVID times, I guess. So we're gonna change those out too. So step number one, stick your tires out in the sun. These are T50s. These are the ones from Ace Hardware. Do not use an impact gun on these. Ask me how I know. So I cheated, I pre-loosened, except for that one. Put it in gear. Back it off. I'm not on the side of the road, so I'm not gonna use side of the road hand tools. I'm gonna cheat because I'm in the garage. If we're on the side of the road, this would be a completely different video. Depending on how high your stand is and what kind of exhaust you got, you might have to rotate the exhaust out, but I think we'll be okay. We're not okay. We are not okay. If I was making this motorcycle, which I'm not, but if I was, I'd have made this bolt the same size as a lug nut. That bolt, that nut went way over here somewhere. Got it. Sometimes you get shit. Sometimes you can move it out of the way. Got it. So we just pulled it around, put it over here, got the tire out. We'll leave it like that for now, but I'll show you that it's going to go back into place, right? It'll be fine. If you let the air out, it might come out easier. I forgot about that. Also, if you don't air it up before you put it on, it might make it in there easier too. Don't lose that. I've seen all sorts of methods for breaking the beads. There's a clamp method. Just put a board on it and drive over it with a car. I'm sure those are all just fine. I'm sure they are. But that's not how I do it. Keep the TPMS away. You're the one that knows where your paint is, so don't squish the rim. Once it pops, sorry. It's gonna pop on one side, I'm gonna keep squeezing until we get to the other side. Now we can walk it off. Soapy water. What do you want? What do you want?
Brake fluid in my truck.
Oh my god, you're like a fucking needy baby. We need to take off our old weights. Okay, now for the easy part. We're gonna put the new tire on. get yourself the ones that are 24 inches. These are only 14, so I'm gonna have to double up. So these things are directional, right? So there's an arrow that says that way. There's an arrow that says this way. So, two red dots. That's a light spot. That goes where the valve stem is. It's harder than I remember. That's all. It's been a while. try to get that bead on. Of course this thing's busted. Fucking piece of shit. Here we go. One more. Back tires always suck. This is how I'm going to balance the tire. I'm not going to put weights on it. This is a gel. It's not a water. TPMS safe. If you looked at that thing, it's just a hole, right? I'm going to put 3 ounces of this in there, and then I'm going to air it up, and we're done. Foot-pounds. .5, good enough. No. Stop. Move it to the other side. .44 foot-pounds. What did you say? So we're all done on the tire. Tire change, new battery in the new battery in the tire pressure sensor. Up next, I have to change the front tire and the TPMS. Stay tuned. Up next, I have to change the front tire and the